And I think we're going to find that the Keeper of the Heritage presentation tonight is a pretty big surprise. And I'm going to bring up the treasurer of the Newmarket Main Street Corporation and also major festival organizer Dave Legall to do the presentation for this year. Thank you, David.
Hey, thank you, Renan. I ordinarily dress up a little bit better, but didn't have time to get home to change in between acts here tonight, so apologize for that. And I was going to go topless, but I decided to wear my hat, so I'm sure you'll all appreciate that. So for the past 11 years, this being the 12th year, we've given out the Keeper of the Heritage Award. And that award is a special award to somebody, typically a volunteer in the town of Newmarket, who has done outstanding service in many ways. There's a lot of different capacities, and our past keepers are listed in the program book. And if I start reading them, I'll skip somebody. But the locals kind of know the likes of Sylvia and Forbes Getchell, Ethel McIntosh, the Shandas. I mean, we have a long list. Tito Bullier, who's back there somewhere. That's the kind of person who's a keeper of the heritage in Newmarket. So I'd like to, without any further ado, read on here. Despite huge attempts on her part to interfere with the process, it is with great pride that the Newmarket Main Street Committee gives to Suki Kasanave the Keeper of the Heritage Award for 2009. Yes, that is a bit of a surprise, isn't it, Suki? It's not easy to keep a secret amongst us. Well, I have a little bit to read here that Renan wrote up for me, a little bit of a bio of just a few of her accomplishments over the years. For over a decade, Suki has been involved on a daily basis in the building of this festival and other aspects of community building in Newmarket. In 1997, the same year that this festival was born, Suki and several other women began the Newmarket Gardeners, a group that has since flourished and continues with a substantial membership to beautify Newmarket from Route 108 and the downtown to Zion Hill. Through Suki's passion for writing and pulling the community together, the Village Post was begun in 1999, a publication that lasted for over 5 years, helping to report on various community events, meetings, and news of interest to the community. And I will say it's been quite a few years since that has been published, and it was strictly a labor of love. There was no money in it. It was all volunteer work. And to this day, we still hear people saying, boy, we sure missed that Village Post. So thank you, Suki, for that contribution to the town. Thanks to Suki's vision, vigilance, kindness, and constant attention to a myriad of details, the Newmarket Heritage Festival has continued to broaden and deepen its focus with each passing year. Multicultural offerings, fascinating New Hampshire traditions, including a great variety of traditional artisans, inspiring activities for children and families are now the result. The result of Suki's research, hard work, and passion to offer innovative festival programming to festival visitors from all over New Hampshire and beyond. Suki also works professionally as a writer. In addition to having written for over two decades for magazines, newspapers, and television, we would like to draw your attention to tonight to a compendium of essays about the Piscataquis region written in 2002. Called Across Grained in Wiley Waters, A Guide to the Piscataquis Region. Suki's essay in this book entitled Newmarket, Defining Community, speaks to her commitment to Newmarket and Newmarket's history and community. Here are a few of her words. Newmarket is a small town with dramatic skyline. The giant brick and granite mills that sprawl along the banks of the Lamprey River cast deep shadows across Main Street. Long rows of tall mill windows catching the late afternoon light inside, half of the population of Newmarket once labored to the pounding of the looms. All right, page 29 here, we're getting to the end. Yankee farm girls seeking a new independent life, French Canadians who boarded the train bringing them with their families, and at the turn of the century, Eastern Europeans, a thriving Polish community soon developed, as well as a smattering of Russian, Italian, German, and Irish immigrants. Each new group brought their food, their music, and their traditions. No matter what their ethnic background, the residents of Newmarket were united by their labor. Newmarket becomes a community defined by hard work, production, and useful lives. Above it all stand the buildings on the Lamprey River that first shaped this town. The mills, where so many residents work so hard, their presence announces a pride in the past and a vision for the future. The same mills that once melded people of many backgrounds into a new community stand today as tangible reminders that by working together, it becomes possible to achieve a sense of community, a place of belonging. Suki, would you please come on up to the stage now? Watch out for the tape. Here's Ron Lemieux. Almost done. And I would like to add that as treasurer of the Newmarket Main Street Corporation, and I have to write the checks to pull off this gig, of which costs $35,000 to $40,000 a year, I would like to add that over the years, since Suki's been involved with it, in addition to her writing skills, she's also a great grant writer. And in order to help defray the costs of running this, over the years, Suki has, I just added up this morning, has raised close to $40,000 over the years of various grants. So and that is just the grant money. That doesn't include all the sponsor money and several other funding sources, just grants. And grants, if you've ever done one, you know it's a ton of work. It's hours and hours and hours. And after you get awarded the grant, it's hours and hours and hours to tell the grantee how good you did. So again, thank you, Suki, for everything you've done for this town, for this festival. And in honor of that, we have this lovely parting gift for you. And yeah, we hope not, but yeah, you may open it, but yeah. This is, folks, the official Keeper of the Heritage Award for 2009. Well, I don't know. It opens on the other end. Tip it up. Yeah, right there.
Beautiful?
Yeah. And yeah, it's very nice. It's styrofoam and it's recyclable. Do you have any words to say, Suki, while you're
I didn't prepare my speech. not only I'm very appreciative and honored and frankly stunned, amazed, and there are quite a few people who are culprits in this effort. Chief among them is standing next to me, also the person that lives in my house with me, and the whole committee and the Main Street, the Newmarket Main Street Corporation did a good job of a big cover-up. So I'll have to discuss all of this with them later on. But this is really a team effort, so I guess I would really like to say thank you again to the whole planning committee and very beautiful clock to remind us of the passage of time here in Newmarket, which is part of what we're celebrating at this Heritage Festival, both the traditions of the past and I hope the continuation of those traditions into the present. I think that's why the Heritage Festival means so much to all of us. Yeah, there's one other person I'd like to thank, my son, Gabe. You can wave, Gabe. Gabe is an unofficial, becoming more official every year, member of the Heritage Festival Committee, and comes to an awful lot of meetings and helps out in many different ways. So this is a great weekend. I think it symbolizes, I mean, one reason the festival means so much to me is that it's really a chance to come together and celebrate what unites us, not what divides us. And we have so many opportunities today in the world to hear bad news. But this is a chance to come and celebrate so many different cultures and the gifts that so many cultures bring to us. And to take a moment here, and we're very lucky, obviously, to live in this peaceful, beautiful part of the world. And it's a chance for us to do our little part to celebrate diversity and all the gifts from so many different cultures. So thanks to you all for coming out, for appreciating the arts and keeping them alive, and have a great weekend. Thanks.